16, office 16?
Yeah, I have it.
Okay. So we discussed that today about the Excel architecture and reference system, right? In the Excel workbook, one Excel workbook have the sheets, and in the sheet have the row and column, right? Row mm-hmm. and column. And where they interact with row and column, that called cell, and every cell have the address. Just like these cells have an address, is the A1. And I allow your recording, so please start your recording, your class. And starting a recording, press Alt plus R shortcut key, Alt, with Alt and R.
You can record, should I record or you record it?
No, in this Zoom app have a recording facility. I allow the recording. You can start your recording with press your keyboard, Alt key plus R.
Okay.
Right? So you start your record, class recording. When they stop your class, your recording will be saved in your document with Zoom folder.
Okay.
Right? So we discussed the addressing system. In the cell have a cell address A2, E2. How I identify key, E2 is the cell address? Because E is the column name and 6 is the row number. So this cell address will be E6. And this address is the very useful, the connecting, using the formula and connecting the one cell to another cell. In the Excel, we have to do the calculation. It's like 20 and next 30. I want to additions be 20 and 30. You can press the equal for the apply any calculation and formula using the start with equal. And we can directly sum here 20 and plus 30, and we will get the result 50. Right?
Okay.
Your addition not be updated because this is the manual calculation. If we have directly in the cell, we use the directly 20 and plus 30. But I want to, where the change my cell value, data will be updated. That time we use the reference. D4, value of D4 plus value of E4. Then we will get the result, and when the change any cell value, our result will be updated. Right? This reference system for this use that, when they apply the formula calculations, we can use that. Another database system is like Access, SQL. We have using the column field, using the through calculation through field, not in the cell. With calculation only in, with cell only in the Excel, right? So another example for the reference system, we have the sum cells value, cells quantity, just like 80, 60, 50, just like. And I want to plus 20 to every cells figure. So press the equal, select the A2 value, A2 reference, and enter the plus symbol, addition symbol, and 20. Press the enter, then your calculator will show the your results. And I want to same calculation for all data, all cells figure. That time, select your cell address, and you can drag down and copy paste. Your formula will be increased. Just like there is the reference is the A2, A is the column and 2 is the reference, A2 plus 20, and below here is the A3 plus 20. So if you copy your formula below, up, down, left, right, your reference will be increasing and decreasing. For same thing, this is the A2 plus 20, but you can copy to next column, then column reference will be also changed, A2 changed by B2. But but sometimes have the benefits, but sometimes have the problem. Just like I enter our sales 20 here, and I want to every sales figure plus with D1 value of D1. So select here A2 plus and here D1. But problem is that when you drag down and copy most of the below, A2 also changed by A3. This is the required, but I want to fix D1 because D1 replaced to D2 and D2 is the blank set. So I want to D1 is the fixed. No, never change when the copy and paste. For that, we use the absolute reference. Do the absolute reference, apply the dollar symbol before your row number and before the column number. If you want to fix that call freeze, that call absolute, you want to freeze your row, then enter the dollar, apply the dollar sign before the row number. And when you drop down, then you can show here your value. One is the fix. Never change the initial value. But you have drag and copy push to next column, that time D change by E. Because apply the dollar symbol before of the row number, before the number, row number. If you want to fix your column number also, then you can apply the dollar symbol before the column name. That time, if you have any copy and paste, any changing, any drop down, anywhere, your D1 is fixed. Mr. Dwig, it is clear? Hello? Mr. Duke, I don't listen to you. Hello? I can't hear you.
Can you hear me?
No. Now you hear you.
Okay.
This referencing system will be clear?
Yeah, so I'm already at intermediate level, so I already know these things. So you can skip the basics.
Let me be because I don't know which topic have you know, which topic have you not know. So I follow our course syllabus, basic to advanced, right? And this addition system is the very important for the calculations, normal calculation and also the large calculation. So I think so you. Mm-hmm. So I will follow our course and some classes, maybe some topic you already know, but I don't know if this topic you know and this topic have which level you or know, you know. So I will follow our course syllabus, right?
Okay.
Okay.
Can you send the syllabus to me?
Okay.
I see the syllabus?
Okay, if you want to the course syllabus, log on the website ipdindia.com. Okay, and scroll down.
Okay.
There is the course outline. And this is your course syllabus. So today discussing about this topic, workbooks okay. And worksheet handling. So today topic is the workbook and worksheet handling. After that, advanced formatting, and after that, next topic. So today discuss about workbook and file handling. So first we discussed about the references, cell references, because you not understanding the cell references, you do not any calculation or any link with your cell to cell and file to file. So this is the very important.
Okay.
Next, we want to some information about your topic, about the Excel command. If you in future maybe forget some details of the topic, just like I teach you the conditional formatting, but after 2 months, you will forward this topic. But some type of the hints and sometimes some little information if you receive, then you remind your course. So go the click on the your command. This is the your Excel screen tips. This is the option screen tips. If you drag over your command and show here the screen tips. And also in the screen tip, there is the tell me more. If you click here, tell me more, then you can get the Excel help. Sometimes we have get the problem about the Excel and Excel formula, and many people first searching on the Google and take the article, take the result from the articles and different resources. But I suggest you, if in future, if you have any doubts, any problem in your topic, and you want to know more about any Excel topic and formula, first search in your Excel help. Just like I want to know about the Excel limitations, how many limitations about the Excel figure, just like row and column head, number of sheets, everything. So we search here limits. And also search the limit, and also here, this is the symbol of the help, also search here limits.
Mm-hmm.
Is it Excel limits? Excel limits, Excel specifications and limits, click here. And you can get here every Excel feature and limit. Number of row and column in the worksheet, number of column width, row heights, page breaks, number of character in the contain one cell, everything about Excel limitation. So I suggest you, after this class, please read this article, read this help, and some topic memorize, because in future, if you apply the formula and apply the BBA course, this limitation help you validate your course. Right, Mr. D?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, and second thing, I want to know about shortcuts. Every feature you can apply from your menu bar, but we have the shortcuts. If you just like paste, if you paste Control and V, then apply the paste. So in the research, we are getting the result. If you work with your keyboard mostly, then your speed will be greater than 30% using the mouse. Right. So, if you want to extract the shortcut key list topic wise, so you can also search on the Excel help. Shortcuts. And this is the shortcut, keyboard shortcut in the Excel windows. And here is your shortcuts. You close your workbook, open workbook, go to the home tab, save as a workbook. Every function keyboard mentioned in this list. So print out this list and stay with your workstation, and daily basis do the practice. Because on the shortcut command, need to practice. It's not a memorize. Only for need to practice. Just like if you want to press your enter, you can't see your keyboard. Your finger have a practice with your key relation, the key with enter and your finger. So mm-hmm. Never see your keyboard key, where is the enter, and then you press your enter. Because in enter key you have used the daily basis many times, so your mind and finger will be related, and location will be related with your
mm-hmm.
keyboard key. Just like that, this is the psychological part. Okay, so this is a shortcut key. You can also apply here, but if you some topic have not a shortcut key, just like if you want to apply the all border, and all border have no any shortcut, direct shortcut, then you can using the alternate key and do the apply the your shortcut, apply your all border with your keyboard. On keyboard, press the Alt key. When you use pressing the Alt key, on menu bar have one character. This character is the shortcut for your menu bar. So our all border command in the home menu bar. So this is the H character. So I press the H, and when the pressing the H key in the home menu bar, every function, every command has assigned one key. So on the border, assign the B. So place here the B, and this is the all border. Place this is the A character. So place. So next time we remind the sequence H Alt H for home, B for border, or A for all border. This is the your shortcut. Any doubts, sir? If you go through any menu bar, any command, any option in the menu bar, you can use the alternative key. Press the Alt key, and just I want to go to the data menu bar. On the data menu bar, have the character A. Press the A. In the data menu bar, have a which options? Every option assigned the one key. Which key you want to? Just like I want to form access, keep on the form access, press FA1. So apply here. So this is the alternative. It is clear, Mr. Dio?
Your microphone keeps cutting off. Is there an issue?
One second. Now it's clear?
Yeah. Just sometimes just cut off and then they can't hear you.
Because here is some weather problem. Weather is not good, so our Wi-Fi signal will be interrupt.
Sorry, say it again.
Because here in the my palace, weather is not good. Weather is the cloudy. So, and wind is the very high speed, so Wi-Fi signal will be interrupted.
Okay,
so some internet connection problem will be, sometime voice is not coming. My voice is not coming for you. If then you can tell me the repeat, I will repeat it.
Okay,
then do you understand the alternative key? If you want to go through any menu bar with keyboards, press the Alt key, and every menu bar have assigned the one shortcut key. Which menu bar enter, if you want to enter, press your key, and in the menu bar every function assigns the one also. So which function have the direct shortcut key, then you can use these features. Go through the shortcut key, alternative key is the Alt key. And next is we discussed about the templates. Do you know what is a template?
A template?
Yeah, right, template.
No.
Okay, I suggest you. In the office, you can create the reports. So creating the reports, previous report will be saved as the new report's name. And clear the previous data and enter the new data, right? But form the daily basis is format the same, only for data will be changed. Daily reports like daily reports, monthly reports, your figure will be changed, but report format will be same the same day. If you have required to create the one invoice format, one work order format, any type of report in the past time you could never create it, and you have never idea ki this report how can create it, how can look like. On the file menu bar, pressing on the new command, there is the inbuilt Microsoft template. Microsoft offered you three types of the templates. This is the inbuilt template. You can also design the template. We'll discuss about the inbuilt templates. Right? Just like calendar, just like school planner, students' rules, run project, project tracker, every time. And this is a very useful and popular templates, but you can search your templates and you also see the search by the category, just like financial management. When they click on the financial management,
okay,
and so here the template, it are reports templates regarding the financial management. This is the invoice. If you require, if you want to use this template, click here and download, create.
Mm-hmm.
In this file, this template inserted. Right?
Okay.
And we change the slogan, logo, and details, and use it. So this is the inbuilt template. But do you want to create a template? We have the one small format, and daily basis the I have used that and changed the figure. So create here, just like first create one format, daily sales reports, and increase the size here. Alright, date. And here the serial number, name, year, and balance. And total. Apply the sum formula. Apply this board, right? And go to the page layout view, or there is the grid line, and click on the view, and click on the view, grid line will be in the report. And leave the This is our report form. Daily basis pay, fill that, clear the previous data, and fill the new data and save the new name. Same again to again tomorrow, clear the yesterday data, clear the data, and fill the tomorrow data and save the tomorrow name. So, for first time when they're creating a report and when they clear the report, save as. Save it as a template, Excel template. Your locations, name, mm-hmm. Save. Right?
Save. Okay.
And close the report. Next day, the first thing, so yeah, your template icon will be changed. Next time, when you double click and open this, if you double click any time to open this file, this is the sales one, or every time you got the blank data, blank format. Okay, fill the report, and when the sale got a new name, just like if you create the new workbook, then the Excel give you the book one, book two, book three, Just like that, sales 1, sales 2, sales 3. When they all open this file. That called templates. In the office, we have the 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 report, daily basis report, and create the daily basis your reports. So I suggest you to please create the templates and use the templates. If you use the templates, your time will be saved and your format will be not changeable, because you can't change your templates, right? The templates is the fix. Mr. Dick, is it clear? So do you know about the templates? Templates is the very important part. If you create the report format via templates, you have listed key daily basis, how many reports will be created. And if you're not in the office and your work will be handled another person's, I told you another person in this folder have the template, fill the report, fill the your information there, send the concerned person.
Wait, so you said when I close it, it doesn't save?
Right. Okay.
So if you put like a date, if you put a date in there, you save it and you close out, you open again, the date's gone, or?
Yeah. Day to day you can open and change here, because your template will be created and template format will be never changed in the future. If you change the template, then again save as the same name, the same location, then it will change.
Okay, can you show that?
Just like I want to change this. Just like I want to change some features in these templates.
Okay.
Because we have required some changes. Just like balance, I want to apply the formula for the balance, the CR minus DR, debit minus credit, and credit plus balance minus debit, right? We have to apply this formula here. But this formula not changing your original template format, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to change this template format, then you have save as the same location, the desktop, and same extension, same file type.
Mm-hmm.
Right. With same name, same location, same name, or same file type. Then if you just save here, you want to already exit, you want to replace it, press OK. Then close here. Then you have open these sales, then your update will be get you updated. So you cannot easily change your template, right? Is it clear, Mr. B?
Okay.
Go to the next topic. Next topic is the maintain your file property. Just like we have the file, another file, this is chart one. Without open, I can't understand in this file have a say what type of the data, what type of the report. Because this file created the last 1-3 year, 1 year, 6 months, I forget what data will be saved here. So before open this file, I can't know that what type of the data will be saved in this file. But you have maintained this file property when you're creating, that time you can just go through the mouse and show the file name. Just like here, if we have the function one, so here, title, Excel VBA functions, And also here, title Excel VBA form example. I know this is the form example, VBA form example.
Mm-hmm.
Like that, on this chart, we have good right click on the chart file icons or click the properties. And last type is the details and enter your file details. In this sheet, basic chart jump for batch and you can also enter your subject tag. You know about the tag? What is the tag?
Mm-hmm.
You can also enter here the tag. Tag helps you the searching your file because in future you have forget the name. So mm-hmm. enter here the different charts. It's like graph, just like dashboard. In future, we have searched any graphs and dashboard name of dashboard, then it will file will be sold because we maintain the tag and press the apply and open. In future, even the go through a cursor, so here your title to this basic chart example for the Saturday night. So I can understand that this is the example. So mm-hmm. if you have any important file in the office and maybe in future it will be used that and possibly you can forget your name and details this file. So maintain the property this file. Okay?
Yep.
And if you want to show your property, just like click on go to the cursor and you can also use the properties here. This is a file property. I think this is the no. But can't you use that? Right?
Mm-hmm.
So today we will discuss about Excel referencing system. Second topic, we are using the help. With help, you can get the information about your Excel command. This is just like limitations and shortcuts. Secondly, we discussed about the templates. How can you use the templates? And third example will be used. How can maintain the properties? And tomorrow will be discussed about the change the setting of the Excel application. Some people ask me why discuss about Excel setting change in the second class? Because I think the first time we can use the any device and we set the hour. According with me, just like you can buy or any mobile phones, new mobile phones. Then first you change the screen, change your ringtones, change the alarms. But mobile company will be give you the default setting. But we can change the according us, right? So we have on the file menu bar, we have the Excel option, and in the Excel option, some features have the disturb in the hour bar, and some setting will be changed, and you can save your minute your working times. So tomorrow discuss about the Excel option, right?
Mm-hmm.
So today is the finish the class and tomorrow we will discuss because next batch will be coming. So
class from 9:30 to 10:15 my time, right?
Class duration is the average, duration will be average depending on your topic, right? Class duration 40 to 1 hour, 40 minutes to 1 hour.
45 to 1 hour, okay.
Some classes have the 35 to 40 minutes, some classes have the 50 minutes, some classes have the 1 hour, depending on their topics.
Okay. So
and
from 9:30?
And your question.
Start from 9:30?
Okay.
Start from.
Tomorrow will be join the same time, and I'll send you a link, new link, and discuss about the Excel setting. But today will be please read about the Excel settings and Excel sort. Right? This is your homework. You read your Excel settings. Excel limitation. List of the Excel limitations and list of the shortcuts. And okay. Speak from the your help me. Excel help.
Okay.
Okay. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.